Problem 3. The triangle ABC has AB equal to CA and BC is its longest side. The point N is on the side BC and BN is equal to AB. The line perpendicular to AB, which passes through N, meets AB at M. Prove that the line MN divides both the area and the perimeter of triangle ABC into equal parts.
We have an isosceles triangle ABC, so the angle ABC is equal to the angle BCA. Now, the trick in this question is to take the triangle AMN and reflect it in the line MN, so that the point A becomes the point A dashed. Then I have two congruent right-angled triangles, AMN and A dashed NM. So this means that the angles A dashed N and A dashed AN are equal. However, the original question told us that AB was the same length as BN, so that the angle BNA is the same size as the angle BAN. So that means that the supplement of the angle NA-A is equal to the supplement of the angle BNA. So these two angles here have the same size. So now when we look at the triangles A-BN and the triangle NCA, we see that we have triangles with the same angles, but they also have a side of the same length because BA is the same length as CA, and so these triangles are also congruent. On either side of MN, we have two pairs of congruent triangles. We have the triangle AMN, congruent to the triangle MA-N, and the triangle CAN, congruent to the triangle BNA-N. This means that AM is the same length as MA dashed, CA is the same length as BN, and NC is the same length as A dashed B. And so MN has divided the length of the original triangle into two equal parts. In the same way, we know that the area of the triangle AMN is the same as the area of the triangle MA dashed N, because they're congruent, and the area of the triangle CAN is the same as the area of the triangle NA dashed B, because they are congruent. So when we add these two areas together, we get the same as these two areas, and so the line MN has divided the original triangle ABC into two equal areas. So, I've shown you one way of solving this problem, but you could also try several others. We could take an altitude from A and the bisector of the angle ABC and see if we could solve it using that diagram. Or we could take the altitude from A and reflect our line MN in that and try and solve it that way. Or we could even use trigonometry. So there are many ways of solving this problem.